March 2011, a strong earthquake struck off Japan, triggering multiple disasters that shocked the whole world. In Taiwan, the leader of an NGO was keeping a close eye on the disasters in Japan. She is the founder of Tsuji Foundation, Dharma Master Zheng Yan.
各位菩萨们，师父天天都在服役哦，生生的呼唤呐，请大家呢时时要戒慎虔诚。Shortly
after the quake struck, Tsuji members sprang into action to prepare for disaster relief. Boxes of relief supplies were promptly shipped to Japan and distributed to disaster survivors in person. Hot meals were also handed out. As it turned out, what the survivors needed most was cash. So within 6 months, Tsuji members held 10 monetary aid distributions in Japan to give out more than 5.3 billion Japanese yen to the disaster survivors. Wherever disasters strike in the world, Tsuji volunteers will be there to provide aid. Clad in their trademark blue and white uniforms, the volunteers have set foot in over 70 countries to bring relief to disaster survivors and to help transform the lives of the impoverished. In 2010, the United Nations Economic and Social Council granted special consultative status to Tsuji. This signifies the international community's recognition of Tsuji's long-term relief efforts worldwide and its spirit of selfless love to relieve suffering. In 2011, Time magazine named Dharma Master Zheng Yan on its list of the 100 most influential people in the world. How did Tsuji begin? The origin of Tsuji can be traced back to 1966. In 1965, the U.S. ceased its aid to Taiwan. Yet, among the island's 12 million people, 1.3 million were still living in poverty. At the time, Master Zheng Yan was cultivating herself in this small wooden hut in Hualien, eastern Taiwan. But unable to bear the sight of other suffering, she was determined to help. On May 14, 1966, she founded Tsuji together with her 6 monastic disciples and 30 housewives. In its early days, Tsuji had very scarce resources. To accumulate funds to help the poor, the nuns sewed baby shoes for sale, while the 30 housewives each set aside 50 NT cents from their grocery money every day and saved it into a bamboo coin bank. It is this spirit of hard work and frugality that helped lay the foundation for Tsuji's future development. In those days, Master Zheng Yan would personally visit the poor together with the volunteers. And this was the first step on the path leading Tsuji to become an NGO that provides aid around the world today. In the 70s, there were very limited medical resources in eastern Taiwan. Many people fell ill due to poverty and became poor as a result. To provide medical care for the sick and poor, in 1972, Tsuji set up a free clinic in downtown Hualien. Although the free clinic had helped many people, inadequate medical facilities remained a problem in eastern Taiwan. Hence, in 1979, Master Zheng Yan decided to build a hospital. However, by 1983, Tsuji only managed to raise 30 million NT dollars, which was far less than the estimated $600 million needed to build a hospital of 500 beds. I saw that Master Zhengyan was very worried. She told me that she was not sure whether and when the hospital could be built, and she was worried that she would let down those who had supported her. After numerous hurdles, Hualien Ziji Hospital was finally built and inaugurated in 1986. Equipped with state-of-the-art facilities, it was the first of its kind in eastern Taiwan. To better provide patient-centered care and safeguard people's health with love and respect, Ziji has set up 6 hospitals around Taiwan in Hualien, Yuli, Guanshan, Dalian, Taipei, and Taichung. To further its mission of saving lives, in 1993, Ziji established a bone marrow donor registry, which later became Ziji Stem Cell Center in 2002. Today, the center has over 300,000 registered donors in its database. More than 2,800 bone marrow and peripheral blood stem cell donations have been given to patients in 28 countries and regions around the world. Each of these donations is a gift of life and a testament of pure, selfless love. In its third decade, Ziji began to carry out the mission of education. By the year 2000, Ziji's comprehensive educational system was completed when its university, technical college, middle schools, elementary schools, and kindergartens were established. In addition to setting up schools in Taiwan, Ziji also helps to construct or rebuild many schools in other parts of the world. Prior to the start of their anatomy classes, Ziji University's medical students pay their respects to the body donors. Through the service, the school hopes to inspire gratitude, respect, and love in students so they can become humane, caring doctors in the future.
Academic results are not everything. Patients are not interested in the doctor's test scores, but they will remember how skillful and how nice and caring their doctors are. That's what matters.
Apart from instilling moral values in students, for years, Ziji volunteers have also been working in the community, hoping to bring about warm and friendly neighborhoods where people help and care for one another. In 2009, a typhoon caused flooding in Taiwan. Before the water receded, Ziji volunteers were already distributing hot food in disaster areas. Ziji volunteers are grouped into teams according to where they live. When a disaster strikes, volunteers living nearby will immediately contact one another and mobilize to bring aid and offer a shoulder for people to lean on. Besides community volunteers, over 80,000 Ziji volunteers worldwide dedicate themselves to recycling work all year round. Ziji's mission of environmental protection started in 1990, when Master Zhengyan encouraged everyone to do recycling during a public speech. Day and night, rain or shine, these recycling volunteers tirelessly give of themselves to collect and sort recyclables in their community. Thanks to their effort, these plastic bottles are able to be processed and remade into blankets and clothing, which are then given to those in need. Proceeds from selling the recyclables are used to support Tsuji's Dai TV station.
Thank you for joining us.
Founded in 1998, Dai TV is a global satellite TV operator that broadcasts a variety of wholesome programming to serve viewers around the world. Apart from Dai TV, Tsuji's cultural mission also includes publications and radio programs that report stories about the bright side of humanity. Through these different forms of media and the internet, Tsuji hopes to promote wholesome values as well as create a cycle of goodness worldwide. Purifying people's hearts and minds, creating a cycle of goodness in the world. This is the mission and responsibility of Tsuji's cultural center. Charity, medicine, education, and culture. These are the four missions of Tsuji, together with bone marrow donation, environmental protection, community volunteerism, and international relief, they are Tsuji's eight footprints. Today, these missions are all being carried out worldwide. Take, for example, Tsuji's international relief effort, which can be traced back to 1991. In 1991, a powerful storm struck Bangladesh, claiming around 140,000 lives. In response, Tsuji volunteers in the U.S. held a donation drive and gave the funds collected to the Red Cross. In the same year, China was devastated by severe flooding. Over 200 million people in 19 provinces were affected. In the aftermath of the disaster, Tsuji volunteers took to the streets to fundraise for the people in China. This was Tsuji's first relief effort in China. Ever since then, Tsuji volunteers have been carrying out various aid projects in China, leaving their footprints in many provinces across the country. In Xinjiang, Tsuji helped rebuild two schools destroyed by a strong earthquake in 2003. In Tibet, Tsuji sponsored a project to help prevent brick tea fluorosis among the Tibetans. In Gansu, since 1998, Tsuji has helped construct over 20,000 water cisterns to collect rainwater, as well as build two elementary schools. However, due to erratic climate conditions, droughts worsened. With no rain, the cisterns could no longer serve their purpose. Hence, Tsuji decided to help relocate the locals by building a new village for them. In early 2011, the villagers happily moved into their new homes. In the newly built village, the residents are given a new lease on life. In fact, apart from China, since 1991 up to now, Tsuji has provided aid to over 70 countries around the world. From Taiwan and China to all across the world, wherever there are disasters, Tsuji volunteers can be seen bringing aid to those affected. In Iran, 2003, Tsuji provided emergency relief and medical care to the quake survivors. As well as help rebuild. Five school. Is there? distributed. To the local to ch-
In Orstrick
Afghanistan. Volunteer. Just did aid. GCAT. trip in Afghanistan. Saji volunteers to aid to and a during the errata quarry years from relief support. or into three. Tears. Tribute really. camp.
Give the best.
South Africa, Tsuji set up over 500 vocational training stations, helping over 14,000 Zulu women to become self-sufficient. Grateful for Tsuji's help, many have been in South Africa. Tsuji serve as over 500 volunteer locations and training stations, helping over 14,000 goals into the Zulu community to bring Kabika and support out to the support and sick. Passing on the love of the accuracy received for two more people he's to help. Many have indeed and during our return to the search of Tsuji well and Tsuji's volunteers hope most of all, they often go into their community to bring love to both and care and support to the poor and sick and passing on the link of the universe and peeved to more people. All the wish is indeed to bring a relief mission stability in their society. Volunteers hope most of all is to bring love to people. Inspired the layering gorgeous NGO in the Chinese-speaking world. Tsuji originated from a simple little fly which is good evening for us in the loving heart of the poor stabilist Nai-an in their society. Under her guidance, regardless of race, religion, and nationality, Tsuji volunteers work selflessly to spread love throughout the world. Their conviction to serve has remained firm and steadfast for over 40 years. The largest NGO in the Chinese-speaking world. Tsuji region has navigated natural animals and man-made disciples to bodies of goodness continue to ravage the in the love of the world to the heart of the poor. It is all the more important to inspire goodness under her people's guidance. And regardless of red race, religion, and around the nationality, Tsuji volunteers work selflessly to spread love through only when we help and care for one another. Their conviction to serve has when we bring a main front a better future for human and steadfast for over 40 years. As natural and man-made disasters continue to ravage the world today, it is all the more important to inspire goodness in people and spread love around the world. After all, only when we help and care for one another can we bring about a better future for humanity.